Hello and welcome back again to the service and rebuilding of this poljot 3133 movement chronograph. This is it on the time grapher at the moment, so I'm going to try and zoom in for you and let's have a look at the movement slightly closer. I know that the movement has a great influence from the Thankyou movement, but it's still a beautiful movement, very much a lovely movement. The couplings and the chronograph side of this watch was actually disengaged, and so we had to just adjust the depthing cans and things like that there to make sure that it's all zeroing properly. So I'm going to try to zoom in here for you if I can. Now again, I know my video making isn't the best going, but I'd just like to take this opportunity to thank my subscribers out there. It really means a lot, actually. It's really, really encouraging. It really is, and thank you so much for that. I do appreciate it. At some point in the future, I promise to make a video from a full strip down and a full reassemble, but that'll not be for a wee while just yet, but definitely we will do at some point. On the previous video there, you see this watch sitting on the bench, and you probably would have noticed that I hadn't taken out the mainspring, but since that I actually did go on to take the mainspring out. I like to do that. And well, there's a nicely interesting little feature inside the mainspring barrel. It's almost like a clip that holds the mainspring in place, which I thought was quite a nice feature. But it is a beautiful looking watch. It really is. I think chronograph watches are beautiful. So I'm going to take you to my bench here. I have Gera Perigru, I think it's pronounced as, sitting on the bench, and I'm going to let you have a wee look at that in a wee second. Now here it is on the bench here, and it's ironically enough, it's just sitting on a tiny French watch stand. This is the French watch stand my father would have used, and I don't often use it myself, but because of the particular size of this movement here, it fitted absolutely perfect into it. And these are great, just working with it. It's heavy and strong, and doesn't move very easy across the bench, and it just holds the movement really nicely in place, that I'm able to work away removing the actual plates and the screws and things like that there. I normally would work with this here Bergeon one. It's much lighter and it would slide much easier, and you have to be very careful, I find, for the movement which slip or flip clean out of this here movement stand. And this is another one that my father would have had, but my point being today is that some of the old stuff is really hard to beat, and I would love to get myself a larger version of this and maybe try to modify it, because the weight and the movement of it's absolutely fantastic. So this movement is just being made ready to go into the cleaning machine now, and it has an 18 karat gold case and bezel. The expanding bracelet isn't, but anyway, we'll let you see that when it's finished. And thanks a lot for watching, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye bye now.